SpaceX appears to have begun tying up a number of loose ends at Starship's first orbital launch site, potentially setting the stage for major rocket testing CEO Elon Musk has stated could begin next month. Last but not least, SpaceX performed multiple tests of the pad's orbital launch mount, the giant steel structure that will support Super Heavy, hold the booster down during testing and before liftoff, and supply it with thousands of tons of propellant. On November 21, SpaceX completed the first of those tests, seemingly venting an unknown gas out of the mount. More likely than not, it was the first simultaneous test of all 20 of the mount's Raptor Boost engine gas supplies, which, having no need to reignite in flight, will rely on ground gas supplies for ignition. Each of Super Heavy's 20 outer Raptor engines has a small umbilical and quick disconnect mechanism, resulting in what is likely the most mechanically complex rocket launch mount ever built. On November 22, the Orbital Launch Mount's booster quick disconnect panel actuated for the first time, showing off the first glimpse of how it will move forward, to connect to Super Heavy after a booster is installed on the mount. To prevent its sensitive components from being practically incinerated each launch, the mount's QD panel will also need to rapidly move away from Super Heavy just before liftoff. Aside from simply avoiding direct impingement from the several thousand degree plume, created by 29 to 33 Raptor engines at full thrust, that movement will also tie into some kind of hood, seamlessly actuating hatches that will close to truly protect the device. That hood was itself spotted for the first time on November 21, and will likely be installed on the launch mount, and over the naked QD mechanism in the very near future. Finally, over the last week or so, SpaceX has begun installing a number of new pipes on and around the launch mount, likely assembling a water deluge system that will help manage the extreme thermal and acoustic environment created by the most powerful rocket in history shortly before and after liftoff. When activated, a spray bar circling the mount's full interior circumference will likely unleash several tons of water per second in a giant artificial waterfall, hopefully preventing Super Heavy from damaging itself with the sheer sound produced by its Raptor engines, or violently eroding the surrounding pad or launch mount legs with its plume. Ultimately, once all the tower, arm, and mount work described above is completed, the only obvious thing standing between the orbital launch pad and the first Super Heavy booster testing, and first orbital Starship launch, will be the delivery of liquid methane fuel, which could easily begin any day now. To build a fully reusable launch system for its interplanetary Starship vehicle, SpaceX has had to solve technical challenges, such as slowing the massive spacecraft down as it re-enters Earth's atmosphere, near orbital velocities. But perhaps the biggest challenge is always with rockets is fairly mundane, its mass. The goal with a rocket is to build the lightest possible vehicle, with the greatest amount of performance. In theory it sounds simple, but in practice containing volatile liquids at high pressures is anything but simple, and with a fully reusable launch system, SpaceX has the added challenge of building vehicles that can withstand the rigor of launch, perform in a vacuum, and then return screaming through the atmosphere to land back at sea level pressures. The things need to build light, strong, and adaptable vehicles sometimes leads to interesting design choices. And SpaceX orbital launch mount, another reason is that Super Heavy booster does not have legs to land on concrete. As usual, its purpose is to reduce the overall weight, making it possible to carry more cargo and fuel to orbit and to Mars. So the design team came up with the idea of building a catch tower and also build orbital launch mount to place Super Heavy booster and support Starship to prepare for the next launch. What will be the dimensions of the orbital launch mount on the construction sites in Boca Chica? Everything seems to be huge. The largest building is Starship launch tower on the launch site, and it surpasses everything. A launch tower with a height of about 140 meters is able to catch. Also huge booster of the Starship. Besides the launch tower, the launch table is another important construction project that is being worked on day and night, in order to be ready for operation at the end of December and beginning of January 2022. The orbital launch mount consists of two main components, six columns and one orbital launch table. Hexagonal symmetry all the way down to the mount's foundation piling suggests that SpaceX's new Starship pad design will begin with the bare minimum needed for a sturdy launch pad. SpaceX may change the design for Super Heavy, but Starship's thrust section is attached to a skirt with six strengthened sections that host landing legs and hold down clamps. The sheer heft of 2 meters 6 feet wide steel and rebar columns filled with concrete and pilings at least as wide and more than 30 meters, 100 feet deep, certainly hints at a final structure capable of surviving the fury of Starship's super heavy booster, and the upper part of the foot poles is being assembled by talented SpaceX engineers in a different area. Predicting both parts will be about 20 meters tall, and according to my opinion is about 12 to 15 meters. How does the structure design and operation of each part of orbital launch mount? The 6 columns of the orbital launch mo have been filled with concrete and built into a solid hexagon next to the launch tower. The Starship test table these clamps will make by stainless steel and be designed to be very flexible, activated by a remote control system. It will help to fix the super heavy booster when it is placed on the launch pad. The same time, it is also very flexible while unfolding during Starship launch. One of the special design points of orbital launch mount are cutouts in the launch table for sound suppression water system. It will create a massive flow rate of 300,000 gallons water per minute. With orbital launch mount, so have you ever wondered how these two new designs work together? During an orbital launch attempt, a reusable super heavy first stage booster will detach from the Starship and come back to Earth for a vertical landing. Eventually, SpaceX wants to use catcher arms on the launch tower to capture the descending first stage after catching the super heavy booster. The 4 fins attached to its body will be released to prevent the first stage from falling. At the same time, it will rotate a distance so that it can accurately place the super heavy in the correct position of the orbital launch mount. At this point, the clamps on the launch table adjust to fix the first stage, then the capture tower will release the booster's body and rotate back to its original position, and the fins will also fold down. The Starship will then be installed and continue for the next launch at the orbital launch mount. To put designs like this into practice, it would require years of refinement and experimentation, be rapidly inspected, refueled, and launched again. Whether this all works out remains to be seen. SpaceX has tried many things in the past in regard to rockets, only to discard these ideas. Super Heavy will be as tall as the entirety of a Falcon 9 or Falcon Heavy rocket, first stage, second stage, and payload fairing included. Powered by up to 31 Raptor engines, the Super Heavy booster will produce upwards of 72,000 kilonewtons, 16 million lbf of thrust at liftoff, 9 times the thrust of Falcon 9, triple the thrust of Falcon Heavy, and double the thrust of Saturn V, the most powerful liquid fuel rocket ever to reach orbit. Combined with Starship, the full stack will weigh roughly 5,000 metric tons, 11 million pounds, fully fueled. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.